Hello and thank you for watching. This is STSC and I'm back again with a new LEGO Transformer. Of course, this is my G1RC and I think it's pretty accurate. Of course, there are some inherent limitations to LEGO. It's always going to be a bit blocky unless you're building at a very large scale. But I think, all in all, I managed to make this look pretty sleek. Now, there are some major issues, unfortunately. First of all, this should be pink. Just had to be white for the transformation. Same with this panel. Another issue, should have seats. There's these seat backs here, or at least they're supposed to be seat backs, but unfortunately, with how it transforms, I just couldn't quite fit those interior details. But now for the biggest issue, she doesn't have wheels. Now, I know that might seem like a really big problem for a car, but personally, I think for this design, this very futuristic look, she doesn't really need them. Yeah, she can't roll, but from most angles, you can probably hardly tell they're not there, especially considering on RC, the wheels barely show in the animation, that is. I consider this figure to be minifigure scale, so here's a minifigure for comparison. It's not perfect. Of course, the minifigure can't ride in the seats, considering there are none. The most you can do is really just have them stand there. Maybe it's a bit too small, maybe it's a bit too big. Honestly, I didn't look at any references for this, because to me, the main importance is how robot modes scale, and this figure scales well with my other Autobots, which I will show in other videos in the future. And that's about all there is to say about RC in her car mode, so I guess it's time to transform. And here we have RC in her robot mode, and I think this is probably the better of the two modes. And just to get it out of the way, here's a minifigure for scale. So we're gonna have to address the elephant in the room. Yes, it's G1RC, so she has a backpack. Now, personally, I think it manages the kibble pretty well. The only kibble she really has is this, which I think hugs close enough together and is close enough to the back that it doesn't really get in the way too much, and I think it looks fine. All things considered, for a G1RC, I think it could be much worse. So we got that out of the way, which means we can now talk articulation. She's got a fair amount. Her head here is on a T-joint. Now, it is on droid arms, so I try not to twist it, because of course the friction at the neck is much greater than the friction here, and it's very easy to break droid arms, so if you're gonna move it, kind of bring it up and hold it by the T-joint and then twist it. But she gets the full 360, and she can look up and down. Then at the arm, she has another T-joint. In this case, it's kind of connected to two separate pieces, the shoulder armor and the arm. So this does mean that the joint isn't actually at the top of the shoulder, but I think it works out fine. This is about as far forward as the arm can go, but once you bring out the shoulder, then it can go out farther. So, as long as you're okay with the shoulder looking a bit wonky, she can pretty much get the full range of that. And then the arm can go all the way up like a T, and can bend. Unfortunately, no lateral bicep movement. This is not a ball joint, it's just a single hinge, but you can rotate at the wrist. Then at the waist, there is a swivel. And then another T-joint at the hips, so you can go all the way out. It's a bit tricky because there is this piece here that you have to mind, you have to make sure that it stays aligned. Then at the knees, there's a ball joint which can get just about a 90 and can rotate out. and then another T-joint at the feet so they can tilt and rotate. For accessories, RC has her two blaster pistols, which, as you can see, I've posed her holding. It was tricky getting her balanced like that, and I actually twisted this toe joint to get her to do it. Now, if I put her more in a stable pose, there you go. You can see there's the guns. They're very simple, just kind of blocks. You can take it off, and I'll show it up close. Yep, that's it. Really not breaking the bank with this build. Not treading new ground. But I think it works well enough. So that's all for RC. If you enjoyed the build, please check out my channel and my other social medias, which will be linked in the description. And I guess I'll see you next time, whenever that is.